For a moment, let's think about something that makes you have fun. Something like watching an engaging movie, reading a detailed book, a show filled with a load of depth, listening to a euphoric album. All of these things can give you a fun time, right? What about video games? One game franchise that comes to mind whenever I think of a fun time is Call of Duty Black Ops. I know, the Call of Duty franchise is easily hateable due to its at-large times, poor campaigns, use and popularization of microtransactions, and its yearly release schedule, causing the games to be half-baked. It can feel like Activision doesn't even really care about the series. One thing that is undeniably peak about the franchise, however, is the incredible and bizarre zombie side mode that was spawned from a silly idea in 2008. Except this isn't a video about zombies in general, but a specific map that ended the first Black Ops. I'm sure by the title of the video, you already know what map that is. The Moon. If you are a fan of zombies, think of everything fun about the series. The endless rounds, the fun Easter eggs, the awesome guns, the perks, the pack-a-punch, the designs of the maps, or even the crazy storyline. Everything about the series is so fun and cool, it's insane these maps haven't come together to form its own game. But if I may be bold for a second, this map has to be the worst thing to ever come out of human creativity. A bold claim, I know, but it's one I'm going to stick through, and hopefully by the end of the video you can somewhat agree with me, or at least understand why I have come to this conclusion. Don't get me wrong, this heap of trash called a paid product isn't entirely bad. It has a few redeeming qualities about it that make me think fun. Yeah, look, I'm not gonna lie, I am never going to think fondly about this map, and you shouldn't either. I'm sick of the intro, let's just cut to the whys, yeah? No, not everything about this map is terrible. There are redeeming parts to it that I actually do like. One thing I enjoy about this map is the actual design of it. Not the layout, I'll talk about that more later. But the visuals and the atmosphere of this map are really nice. One thing I will point out is that my friends and I played the Black Ops 3 remaster for the Zombies Chronicles. The BO1 version definitely feels darker and creepier, but overall worse for obvious reasons. The second thing about this map is actually a double-edged sword, being the Wonder Weapons. There are three new wonder weapons in this map, those being the Wavegun, Gersh device, and the Quantum Entanglement device, better known as the QEDs, the latter two being grenades and the Wavegun being a 2-in-1. These are really cool weapons that are mainly exclusive to the Moon map. The Wavegun, as I said earlier, has two modes, and they're both pretty fun. One just straight up swells the zombies, and it looks really funny. The Gersh device is cool too, just being a massive black hole, great for training. The QED is kind of butt, honestly. Seems just send in a gun? I don't really get it, but it's okay since, you know, you're not gonna fucking get these anyway. And that's basically where I stopped complimenting the game. Like, I've tried to think of more things to like about this map, but I failed to draw up anything every single time. All I think about is how bad the map is. The map is so bad. It's bad the moment it starts. Like, the moment you sit through the loading screen, you get launched into actual chaos. You start your spawn on Earth, or Area 51. There are infinitely spawning zombies and hellhounds, and all you have is a 1911. Yeah. You might be asking, how the hell are you even supposed to survive that? Good point. You're not supposed to. You're supposed to teleport away after surviving for like 40 seconds. Like, okay? Can you explain the use of this? You're meant to return here later, as there's like perks, pack-a-punch, and important steps to the Easter egg here, but why have this area? I guess by the time you get back, you already have good weapons and maybe a good perk, but it doesn't suddenly make this area good. This is the definition of making something hard by making it unenjoyable and impossible. A great example that might help you understand how bad this is in, let's say, Skyrim. You decide you want a challenge, right? You select legendary difficulty. Well, guess what? It doesn't make the game harder, it just makes the game unplayable and enjoyable. Your attacks do a quarter of the damage, and the enemy does twice as much damage. Explain to me how that is good design. Explain to me how that is a good challenge. Go ahead, I'll wait. Yeah, you can't say shit, can you? There's a reason that, once again, the fans of Bethesda games fixed their games by making Legendary fun by making everyone's attacks do twice the amount of damage. It's the exact same here. Oh, and that's not all! There's actually a second spawn in the map, one that leads you to the majority of the map, which is the Faded Moon. You're instantly supposed to put on this stupid PES, which stands for Pressurized External Suits. They're literally just astronaut suits. So, whenever you do have them on, you have the option to take it off, for whatever reason. Anyway, actually, no. Let me rant here for a second. What is the point of this suit? Look, I get it. It's space. You gotta put on a suit. Okay, cool. But like, what is the reason you can take it off? Why can't it just later be replaced by the hacking device? It's just so redundant. The whole starting of this map is just completely unnecessary. It should have just started in the Griffin station with your suits already on. Boom! That cuts out so much unnecessary shit.
Oh, but Jaiden, what about the pack-a-punch and perks there?
move them. Duh. Anyway, that's not even the worst part about the spawn. There's this dude that randomly spawns and acts like a quote-unquote mini-boss of sorts, but he's not a mini-boss. I don't think he's given an actual name, but Nikolai calls him Cosmonaut, so that's what we're gonna call him. He's no Panzer. He's no Warden. He literally just walks over to you slowly, grabs you, teleports you, and then steals your perks. That's not threatening or scary. You know what it is? That's an annoying asshole. That's just a bully. Whenever the Warden would spawn in Mob of the Dead, I'd get a little nervous. Times that by 10 whenever the Panzer would spawn. This dude? This quote-unquote Cosmonaut?
He's the equivalent of you walking to class and then some random jock knocks down your books that are randomly in your hand and not in your bag for no genuine reason.
As for actually exiting the spawn, you have two tunnels, 6 and 11, that lead into the triangle thing. I don't even know what it's called. I also don't really care. The main point here is that this map is so fucking cramped. Like, every hallway is 2 inches wide, 4 inches tall, and they expect a 6-foot German scientist to fit through here with a crowd of zombies. This wouldn't be such a big problem if most of the run wasn't dependent on you training while you roll the box, play Simon Says, do a hacker minigame, etc, etc.
Look, I'll touch on the god-awful Easter egg later, but it just seems so counterintuitive to have these tight and claustrophobic halls and then have 40 zombies and random cosmonauts that are coming to steal your perks.
That's stupid. Actually, that's just poor design. At this point, I feel like they weren't even thinking for a moment how bad their design was and put the aesthetic of the map over the functionality of it.
One thing that made me incredibly enraged was the perk placement. Think for a moment of the first perk you got when you have enough points.
You'll kick?
I know for a fact your ass is not getting that expensive ass thing. No, you're gonna get like Juggernog or Speed Cola, right? Jug is considerably cheap and Speed Cola has several functions besides just reloading quicker, which will save your life. So, where are they on the map? Where on the moon? The titular moon are they? I'll let you look. Oh wait, they are on the moon! They're back on the Earth!
So every time you want to go get arguably the best perks in the game, you have to teleport back to Earth. Which, I mean, it would be fine if every time you travel back to Earth, the perk that showed up wasn't cycled through. Basically, there's only one perk machine located on the entire Earth part of the map. One location to hold two perks. How does that work? It doesn't. Every time you want to come back, it switches to the other one. If you want both perks, you're gonna have to wait your little ass off until that teleporter is ready next round, because guess what? The teleporter has to recharge!
God, this game design is amazing.
You know what? I think it's time to skip to the ugly, or the thought behind the entire map. The Easter egg. This is the reason I had to write this essay and make a video about this map. This stupid ass Easter egg that brings down the map from mediocre to downright horrible. The Easter egg is so complicated, difficult, and extremely relying on RNG, which is a god-awful choice in any game ever. The only time RNG is a good thing in a game is like maybe D&D. So you can understand how bad this Easter egg is, even if you don't play zombies. Now I'm gonna go in depth on how to complete this Easter egg. The Easter egg starts right after you teleport to Griffin Station, obviously turning on the power. A major part is rolling the box. Yeah, this is the RNG factor and the main time waster of the map. You are going to be constantly rolling for the wavegun, Gersh device, and QEDs that I mentioned earlier, all of which are not common and very rare, so they're going to take some time. Sure, there are several things you can do while you grind up 950 points for every roll, but it's just tedious.
Other than rolling the box, you're going to want to do Samantha Says, which is literally just a stupid memory game that you have to play 4 times.
Yeah. After this, you're going to have to get the hacker replacing your PES, meaning you cannot breathe outside. It essentially consists of you going to these little panels and holding square on them, hoping that you did it in time before the invisible timer ends. Oh, and it costs like 500 points to start it up, so there goes your early game funds for the box, or doors, or perks. Who knows? So my complaint earlier with how claustrophobic this map feels really takes a toll on these early steps, because it mainly consists of one friend, God I hope you're doing this with a friend and not by yourself, doing these steps while another trains the last zombie, waiting or rolling the box. Not only is it, again, tedious for the friend doing the step, but also extremely boring for the person training the zombie. Personally, I was the trainer, so hit me up if you need some professional zombie training. I charge $5 per zombie, by the way. So, now comes the best part of the Easter egg. Waiting. God, I love waiting! Except this time, you're just progressing the rounds until you hear on the very quiet intercom that Tunnel 6 has been destroyed. Oh yeah, you probably didn't know about the tunnels when you started, huh? It's not like they were at all obvious. Oh, but make sure you have an ear out, because even if you've never heard of Tunnel 6 or 11 in your life, if that intercom says they are present in one of these tunnels and you happen to go in that tunnel, you're cooked! Like, actually, one of our first runs, two of my friends got down from the excavator actually landing on top of them, meaning I couldn't even revive them. Great game design, Treyarch.
Anyway, this is you waiting for Tunnel 6 to be heard on the intercom while you roll the box and look for some random S-shaped tube that is very important later on in the run. Once you hear about Tunnel 6, you can take the hacker, teleport back to Area 51, teleport back to Spawn or Griffin Station, and you can hack this little panel that essentially lifts up the excavator, leaving you a little surprise. That surprise is actually this little ball called the Vril device. On our first playthrough, I knifed it and lost it immediately, as the moment you melee it, the ball flinks somewhere and you have to be very attentive in order to find it. We spent a good 10 minutes just looking for this thing. If you aren't stupid like us and know that you were supposed to follow it, you'll see it hit the top of an antenna and realize you're stuck. Unless you've had successful box rolls and you have your trusty wave gun. Oh my god, I love this RNG. You pull out your wave gun and shoot it, watching it go into Tunnel 11. It's going to go the other way towards this giant pyramid, the one I mentioned earlier, called the MPD, or the Moon Pyramid Device. Yeah, not a very creative name, but oh well. There's going to be a singular soul tube that pops out that you're going to have to fill. Go and fill that tube real quick, only takes about 25 zombies. For a second, you're gonna get death machines for like 90 seconds and see Samantha. Why? I have no idea. It is such a random place because it's not even like you have a bunch of soul tubes to fill. After you do that, I seriously hope you have the Gersh device or else you're back throwing the box for a couple of rounds, because after you're going back to Area 51 to throw the device at this random corner to teleport some panels, I guess. This is where the Easter egg gets real fun. If you can't tell, I'm lying, obviously. You're gonna teleport back to Griffin Station to throw a QED at the little panels next to the quick revive. They're gonna magically plug themselves into the computer on the right side of the spawn. I seriously hope you collected that S-shaped tube I mentioned earlier briefly, because it is now how you progress. Without it, you're stuck, and this thing has a shitload of places to spawn, so good luck finding it. Genuinely. After that, whoever is Richtofen is going to use the computer. You're gonna see that Richtofen gets the main character treatment at this map, and he is going to sit there for 3 minutes. Yeah. Remember earlier how I mentioned the training? Well, if earlier wasn't bad, this is going to be 10 times worse. It's going to be 3 minutes of Richtofen guessing his password to the computer. Yeah, 3 minutes of that. Yeah, he's a genius scientist but can't fucking remember his password. Look, that's a funny idea and all, but this Easter egg is so goddamn tiring and awful that having to train a zombie for 3 minutes while your friend sits there occasionally pressing square is too much for me. After Richtofen resets his password on Pornhub, he's gonna grab the golden rod thingy that pops up that is extremely important. Don't forget it. You're gonna go back to the MPD and boom, there are 4 more soul tubes that you gotta fill up before you can progress. No problem, just 100 zombies, so hurry up and do that. This is probably going to be the most fun in the entire Easter egg, because you can actually work together and murder zombies for once. Now go plop that golden thingy into the MPD and now whoever is Richtofen gets every single perk! Yeah, he's the main character of this map. If you were zoning out to the story this whole time, this is the part where it's impossible to do so, because these guys are gonna yap for a very long time, and every zombie is gonna change their contacts to get blue eyeballs. Alright, you're so close to the end. All you have to do is painstakingly play Samantha Says successfully 3 times and head back to the MPD and throw a QED at the real device stuck in the MPD. God, a bunch of vocab words and random acronyms coming out of my mouth right now. Anyways, one step remaining, and that is to throw the Gersh device at the real device that is hanging around the Samantha Says. This will call the ball to come up and launch the rockets, destroying the whole Earth, murdering Delirious, and causing the infamous BL2 title screen that everybody knows and love.
Alright, Jaiden. We've heard you talk about the details for a while now, but what makes this map so bad?
Did we just listen to the same overview? Did you skip to this part of the video? First of all, the overpresent RNG. You cannot tell me that rolling the box over and over and over and over and over and over again is fun. No, it's not. It wastes time, points, and effort you could be putting towards other things. It literally makes the Easter egg take a massive pause if you don't already have the 3 required items that are used a total of 5 times, all of which are extremely unnecessary. Tell me, why do I have to use the wavegun to blow the real device down from the antenna? You're telling me my perfect Galil isn't good enough to shoot it down when my knife was? Don't bring up some moon gravity bullshit, the bullets work everywhere else. Why do I have to use the Gersh device to teleport the Area 51 panels? You're telling me it couldn't be a simple collectible like you already have for the S-shaped tube and golden thingy? Why do I have to use the QED to get the real device out of the MPD? Didn't the knife and wave gun work fine before? These things are completely unnecessary and are shoehorned in so the devs could cram these cool wonder weapons that they made just for this map in your face. If these single use items had to be used, you're telling me they couldn't be craftables or something? Why do I have to roll the box to get all of them? I don't even think you can have the QED and Gersh at the same fucking time, so you're completely fucked if you're doing this solo. Hell, I can't even imagine doing this in the original BO1 map. Like, at least in BO3 they give you a gobblegum that lets you re-roll the box and spawn fire sales. That's the thing that carried us and my sanity. Next comes the god-awful training you're forced to do. Like, how are you even supposed to do this solo? It's gotta be hellish. There are countless times where you're just sitting there training a zombie. That's not good game design, Treyarch. I know I've said that a lot, acting like I was the director of Metal Gear Solid 3, but dude, it is not hard to know how to design a map you've been making for years now. They have had a list of 9 solid maps. Surely they must have known how to make one, right?
Oh, but Jaiden, that was their first major map to tackle a big Easter egg.
Good point. Except, not really. Only thing I'll give them is that craftables weren't really a thing until Transit and Origins, but that's it. They had Kino, The Giant, 5, Ascension, Shangri-La, all of which are complicated maps that have little Easter eggs or something to do to unlock the bigger picture. Sure, some of these are simple, but some of them are hard. I've never completed 5, but I know from my childhood that it is one hardest map. They must have known that training is not something to cram into an Easter egg where you are dick-riding a computer, a box, Samantha says, and whatever else you might need to dick-ride in that map. Hell, in Kino there's a great place to train zombies in the entire map, same with the Giants. They knew how to make a map, but they thought to put the shitty feature as a main staple. The most fun part of this map was the soul filling and watching the earth blowing up. I'm not sorry, this is not a good map, and this map was not a fun time. And never will be. Like, seriously, why did they remaster this map? I get it, this connects to the BO3 maps, and it's the whole reason why the world is messed up in BO2, so it does make sense, I guess. But here's the thing, Black Ops 3 Zombies is the smoothest, sexiest, and most stable zombies of all the Treyarch games. The zombies are nice and difficult, the slide is excellent and amazing if you master the slide cancel, and the gobblegum system is incredible. I haven't played BO4, but I don't think I need to in order to know that this game has some of the best gameplay in the franchise. It just makes me sad that they chose to incorporate such a shitty Easter egg in the mix instead of some of my favorite maps, like 5, Mob of the Dead, and Transit. I don't know how beloved these maps are, but they are definitely more interesting than remastering Moon. I get it. Those have a different cast, and the 8 maps they chose do tie in with the 4 maps that are with the BO3 Zombies storyline. Except, they have Shadows of Evil. Why couldn't they put in a little extra elbow grease and remaster those legendary maps? If not all 3, why couldn't they at least remaster Mob of the Dead? That map is legendary. Everything about that map is infinitely more fun, challenging, and more interesting than the Moon premise. 5 is just goofy, and Transit has a better connection with the other maps of BO2. Then again, it also has Robin's voice actor, so that's probably the real reason why they didn't remaster those maps.
Quickly! Beat off the zombies! Beat them off! What? Why are you laughing at me?
I nailed the fumes! Throat closing! I can't breathe! Must drink milk to neutralize the effect!
In my opinion, I would have paid full price $60 to experience every zombies map up to that point, fully remastered with gobblegum put in. Am I alone on this? I don't know, but I don't have a readily available copy of BO2, nor do I have a PS3 or Xbox 360, and I am not paying full price for BO2 on Steam because that is ridiculous. With a very interesting and creative idea in zombies history brought into the mix, the Moon was sure to at least be interesting, right? Who wouldn't want to kill zombies in zero gravity? I mean, imagine throwing cheese at zombies, that sounds sick! Nonetheless, the map has made me want to avoid space for the remainder of my life. Thank you very much. There was a lot they could have done to this map. It wasn't like the initial idea was bad. Like I said a second ago, it is interesting. If they didn't make the Easter egg so important, maybe it could have been better. I mean, Origins is a very Easter egg heavy map and still manages to be enjoyable because it doesn't make the player waste its time or feel stupid. I'm aware that this map is the tide that turns zombies into a story-centric series. I mean, look at World at War or even previous BO1 maps and how simple they are. They have story and Easter eggs, but they aren't complicated or drawn out. Was this their learning curve? I'm sure. Am I in the wrong for needlessly hating on a 10-year-old map? No. They tried, so good job to you, Treyarch. But some of these things are a little ridiculous. That goddamn training makes me so sick, and it's gonna make me have nightmares for the rest of my life. Hey, I mean, it's all okay, right? I mean, the end of this map brought over one of the most fun and beloved and fan-favorite maps. Transit! Everybody loves Transit, right? Right?
Do people like the Transit map? Oh.
Shit!
What I want so much, should never hurt this bad. Never did this before, that's what the Virgin says. We've been generally warned, that's what the surgeon says. God talk to me now, this is an emergency.
Bittersweet, you're gonna be the death for me. I don't want you, but I need you. I love you and hate you at the very same time.